Yo, what's up? So we'll take a quick look at basically the League Star tree. What do you want to be doing? I think to actually progress your maps early, it's much like it was in the previous leagues, in that you're basically just gonna be rushing on Wavering Vision. On Wavering Vision is just OP because as soon as you get it, you get 20 Alice passive skills. So that's the equivalent of completing 20 maps, which early on, since you don't have that much Alice completion, it's just gonna basically enable you to take a lot of passive skills that increases the amount of maps that you drop, and that's just gonna accelerate you from like yellow maps into reds, which is actually kind of funny because usually you're going slowly in yellow maps, and then as soon as like you start filling out all your map nodes, your character is like accelerate like propelled into red tiers and into T16s. So following this strategy is only really effective if you have a build or like you're confident with being able to take on red maps quite early, right? So if you're not confident with that, I think the best strategy is essentially to just like spec essences and stay in tier 6 maps or something like that, instead of like rushing T16s for altars and that sort of stuff. From the start, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna straight up rush here, expect the unexpected. We're not really interested in the notable, rather we're interested in the small node, which gives us 2% chance to grant additional Kirak completions. So when you're completing maps, you'll get additional chances to get Kirak's. Then you want to take the notable here as well for an extra 6%. From there, you could basically just go to Unwavering Vision, and we're just going to take the shortest path. Doesn't matter whether you go left or right here. It's not a big deal. But now you can see that we basically went from having a cap of 132 to a cap of 152. So we have 20 points to spare. So we can get to like 43. So at 23 map completion, which basically is like just wide maps, now you're going to be getting like double the amount of progression that you've had for up until this point. So what you'll do here is now you'll want to be filling out the rest of your maps, and still these nodes, the 2% increased chance to drop an adjacent map, they're going to be the best nodes to take. So we're just going to be filling out as many of them as possible. You can do that as you like, but we want to be getting to 43. So we'll take those, and then we'll also take Shaping the Mountain and Shaping the Skies, and then we'll also be taking this notable. So now we're at 42, and 42 is basically where we wanted to be at. But now as we complete maps, then you'll just be taking the rest of these. This is kind of something that I like doing, and many people do as well, but at any point here you could be taking the shrine nodes. Shrines are nuts. They're very good. When you pair that up with increased effect of shrines on player, and the additional shrine effect that you get when clicking a shrine, you're just going to be getting this like massive boost in damage or speed, or in some cases nothing, because some of the shrines suck. But yeah, you're just going to be getting this massive boost from time to time, which makes your mapping experience easier and nicer and more fun. And we also still have Pact with Energy, though Pact with Energy got mega nerfed. It was giving you the buff permanently, which is the buff being 35% increased damage, as well as max resistance and 15% movement speed. It used to be permanent, but now it's 60 seconds. Although, I think like so once you have kind of like filled out your map nodes and that sort of stuff, it probably is still worth to grab, because 60 seconds is actually quite a decent amount of time, and 35% increased damage is quite a lot early on, but I wouldn't prioritize it as I was in the past. So I mean, you could still grab those nodes with these and then path out to these Sulfide nodes as well, and also grab these, but I wouldn't go as far as grabbing like these other two for the 100% chance. But you can grab those, and now we're at basically 44 Alice completion, and this is where we'll just fill all of the adjacent maps. As we're getting into red tiers and you take all of these adjacent map nodes, now this is the point where basically you're just going to be rushing into red T16s and just doing your either Exarch rotation as like, going from 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and then doing the two bosses and getting your Void Stones basically. And that's the fastest way to get it currently, and how you want to be speccing your Alice for it. But I mean, Pact with Energy, again, this is not a big priority. And if there's anything else that you want to be grabbing early, like maybe you just want to be getting a couple essences, you can always spec into that. This node is like really nice because as you're progressing maps, you'll just be getting a bunch of essences. And if you're playing a claw-based build, as many people will do this league, You just get a few of those decent essences to spam on just like white bases. And there's also these nodes here, Solidarity as well as Planner Tactician, which have 2% increased chance to grant Kirak missions leading up to them. So like you can also grab those, as you'll also be getting increased amount of reports and Kirak missions. And Kirak missions are really important because Kirak missions are gonna allow you to buy maps for currency, all the way up into red maps. They cost, chance orbs and alchemy orbs. But once they start costing chaos orbs, you don't want to be buying them anymore. But most importantly, you can just use the Kirak missions themselves to complete your atlas. You just spam refresh Kirak, you look at his maps. If there's anything worth buying that you don't have, you just hold alt over the map. You'll just be going in game and holding alt over the map, seeing whether you've completed it or not. And if you haven't, you can buy it. And otherwise, you just like run another Kirak and just complete your Atlas that way. And that is the fastest way to get as many passive skills as possible. And by this point, you don't have to have like a full completion to get this Atlas. But by this point, you'll have another Atlas passive skill preset. And thanks to the preset, you can kind of just like leave this tree as it is, click a new preset, and just do whatever farming mechanic you want. I'll be linking this tree as well, for you guys to look at. There's like these arrows here at the top and bottom, sort of show you the order of the nodes, like how I took them. You don't have to follow the order exactly, and that's sort of like how I'm gonna be doing it, and how you get your void stones very quickly on League Start. Yeah, hope you guys found this helpful, and hope to see you guys next time.